my name is Emma Muscat, and I'm going to be representing my country, Malta, in this year's Eurovision in Turin. Welcome to
Hi.
Bulgaria.
Thank you so much.
Is this your first time here in our country?
No, it's not. I visited Bulgaria 5 years ago with my family. We came for a skiing holiday, and it was really beautiful.
So now you're here for a different reason.
Yes.
Did you have time to go around and discover more of Sofia?
No, we haven't had time yet because we arrived last night very late. And this morning we started working quite early, so I haven't had a chance, but I'd really love to visit the city.
Actually, you are here. Can you tell us more why you're here?
Yes, we're here in Sofia to film the live on tape for the Eurovision this evening.
So you haven't filmed it yet?
No, not yet. So we have our first rehearsal today at 5 p.m.
Oh, okay. Do you have already plans how it will go through? Can you share us perhaps some hints what can be expected?
Well, my song is titled I Am What I Am, and it's a song about unity, about being perfect the way we are, accepting ourselves in our own skin, and it's basically an anthem for self-love. So what I can say is that it's a people song, and the biggest element of my song is interacting with the crowd.
And well, of course you won the Maltese national final with a different song.
Mm-hmm.
Can you perhaps tell us more about why you decided to select I Am What I Am for
yeah.
Eurovision?
So basically, we listened to the public's feedback, basically, and our decision was mostly based on feedback, and we decided to challenge Out of Sight, so starting a series of writing and recording sessions. We received many different songs as well from different writers and producers, and the day after the national final we started working, and so after a week of intense work together with my team, we did a listening session, and yes, we decided that I Am What I Am was the best song to represent me and also to represent my country, especially in this time of crisis, I would say, in the world, where we need more peace, more unity, and more love.
And we actually felt that watching the music video, because it's very inclusive, very wholesome. Are you planning to include some elements of the music video for the performance in Turin?
I don't want to spoil anything,
of course.
But yeah, it's a people song, so
we should expect that.
Yes.
Perhaps.
We will see. We'll see.
Actually, in the Eurovision fandom, it's been discussed for a few years whether you will participate in Eurovision, will you try for Malta or perhaps for Italy.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you decide to participate this year specifically? And have you ever thought about trying out in Sanremo maybe?
Well, okay, so your first question, why did I decide to participate this year? Well, basically, I had taken part in a TV program 4 years ago, an Italian TV program, even though I'm Maltese, born and raised. And I decided to, well, 4 years later, I felt ready to go back into a competition, Eurovision being one of the biggest competitions in the world, practically. And yeah, so the past 4 years I've been focusing on myself, on my growth as an artist, on my music, and this year I felt ready to go back into competition. And coincidentally, it's in my second home, basically, in Turin, in Italy. Yeah, that's basically it. And your second question was?
For Sanremo, whether
for Sanremo.
You considered it,
yes.
Or maybe in the future.
Yeah, Sanremo is also one of my biggest dreams. It's definitely my next objective in life, to conquer the stage at the Ariston.
And of course, your vision is in Italy. Do you think that it could be a bit of an advantage for you? Would you feel more comfortable being in Italy and while participating in such a big contest?
Well, I definitely feel at home. I feel comfortable even just knowing that I'm surrounded, like, you know, by Italians as well. But yeah, I feel like everyone has the same chance. It doesn't really change much. I mean, you know, yeah, I'll just give my best and like go to the rest.
And, well, we were thinking, if you imagine Eurovision as a movie, what type of movie would it be? And what would be your role in it? Maybe you can compare it to one of your favorite movies.
One of my favorite movies.
Who's that?
One of my favorite
parts of the movie, maybe.
well, one of my favorite movies is actually Hunger Games. but it has nothing to do with religion. Maybe the competition kind of vibe that you find in Hunger Games could be the competition found in Eurovision.
Yeah, and giving points.
Yeah,
also
giving
to
points. Exactly. Yeah, that is good.
And right now you have a few busy months, but have you planned what would happen after Eurovision? Perhaps we will hear more music from you, an album?
Definitely. An album has been in the pipeline for a while now, and I've been working so hard on new music, on creating a new world of music around me as an artist. And definitely after Eurovision, there'll be much more new music and many new dates, concerts, events.
We can't wait for that to happen, and hopefully you will return to Bulgaria.
Hopefully.
And perhaps give a concert to the fans here.
That would be amazing.
Speaking about fans, do you have a message for the Eurovision fans in Bulgaria?
You do? Yes. So I really hope my song can in some way touch you and some way help you with any struggles in life, anything you might be going through at the moment. And I hope that the message in my song can make you feel more appreciated and loved in this world, because it is an anthem for self-love. Thank you so much for all your support, and see you soon.
Of course, Bulgaria is in the first semi-final,
so
we really hope that you will qualify to the grand final, and our fans will
really
be able to
vote
for you.
Thank you very much. Take care.